We are going to look at project-specific investments. We are not looking at the listed entities.
That's the strategy that IL&FS hopes will pay off, as it sits pretty with a war chest of $895 million in its new real estate fund. The company says it will focus on Tier 1 cities over the next 18 months, focus on projects and not stake buying in beaten down listed companies, and this strategy could fetch returns of 25% per annum.
Well, we are very, very bullish on the residential sector, especially in the Tier 1 cities. And we also believe that commercial property in select markets like Mumbai and Delhi, there is still strong underlying demand over there, which we can capture.
Interestingly, at a time when the market cap of real estate funds is fast eroding, IL&FS has raised more money than it targeted. Most of this has come from overseas investors and sovereign funds at a time when real estate prices across the world are correcting. Earlier, Merrill Lynch had raised $2.6 billion for investment in Asian Realty, whereas Citigroup is raising a multi-billion dollar follow-up fund to invest in China and India. With these numbers being thrown around, developers have been quick to say things are looking up.
I think the question is, what is going to be the quantum of private equity coming into real estate over the next couple of years? And I foresee that post-March 2009, the numbers will start climbing back to the levels we saw at the end of 2007.
However, equity analysts are not so bullish.
So I think we'll have to wait the next couple of quarters to see, what more pain can come out. And it's also got to be put in the context of some of the reliefs that they may end up getting from the financing, especially from the debt side.
For real estate companies, the year has been terrible. Stock prices have crashed and many of them are stuck with land banks bought at exorbitant prices. While new funds could give them an exit road, there is no doubt that companies will have to take a hit before things get better. Alka Shukla, UTVI, Mumbai.